Welcome back, students. Let's see another topic, that is characteristics of living things. Living things are made up of units called as cells. So cells act the basic unit of basic functional and structural unit of life. Now, living things reproduce by sexual as well as asexual reproduction. Cells from two different parents unite to form the first cell of the new organism, and this process is called as sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, new organism is formed from a single parent. That means here no two different parents are required and new organism is formed from a single parent. So this is again the characteristic of living organism, that living things reproduce. Living things are based on the universal genetic code. That means specific living organisms have specific genetic code for their functions. Living things grow and develop. As you can see, a child from 1 year, 2 year, as it grows in years, its body also gets developed. Living things obtain and use materials and energy. They obtain materials and use the energy for their growth and development. Living things respond to their environment. It can be external stimuli, it can be internal stimuli. External stimuli which comes from outside of the organism. Like if you touch a hot plate, you suddenly remove your hands. That is a sign of an external stimuli. So hot plate acts as a stimuli and you remove your hand, the response. Next comes the internal stimuli, in which the stimulus comes from inside the organism. So you can say various health disorders are a sign of internal stimuli. Okay, now living organisms maintain a stable internal environment. You know, there are various organs are there in our body which maintain which function in their own way, and due to this there is a stable internal environment and each organ functions in specific way. Taken as a group, living things change over time. That means you can say adaptations and various changes, behavioral changes or body changes. There are many types of changes observed in the living things. So students, what are the main characteristics of living things we have seen? That living things are first of all made up of cells. They can reproduce by sexual as well as asexual reproduction. Living things have universal genetic code. Living organisms grow and develop. They obtain and use materials and energy. They respond to the external environment, so it can be external stimuli as well as the internal stimuli. Living organisms maintain a stable internal environment with the help of various organs that perform various functions. And living things also can change over a time. So students, in this session we have seen the characteristics of living things. In further session we will have more detailed look regarding the living things. Thank you.